Good evening. I am back, and this will probably be my last video for a few days. I'm just waiting, just killing time before I take my last antibiotic. I have been unwell, bad kidney infection. Anyway, welcome to this channel. This channel looks at life and death. I have some paranormal videos, and when I say looks at life, looks at just about anything that life has to throw at us. I rely a lot on my personal experiences, and I rely a lot on my interests, and a lot of conspiracies, and I also try to tackle really hard subjects. So this channel is very mixed. It doesn't fit neatly into any particular sort of genre or whatever you want to call it. Anyway, I uploaded a few videos tonight, and I've especially been concerned about lithium batteries and mobiles. But I just wondered, you know, we had no mobile phones. So I thought, if we had no mobile phones, how would that happen? And it'd be by a solar flare. So for those of you who know me, when I research facts and everything, I now save it to Word. I don't have in front of me, you know, something to read like the others YouTubers do. So sorry if we've a flash, but I'll switch over to Word. So I wanted to know about the likelihood and everything. So the likelihood of a massive solar flare causing widespread disruption of the electric power grid and rendering mobile phones inoperable is a topic of scientific research and ongoing study. While solar flares and their associated phenomena, such as coronal mass ejections, CMEs, can occur, accurately predicting their specific impact on Earth's infrastructure is challenging. Solar flares are classified based on their intensity, with the most severe ones categorized as X-class flares. CMEs are massive eruptions of plasma and magnetic fields from the sun's surface. If a powerful CME were to impact Earth, it could potentially induce strong geomagnetic storms that might affect electrical systems, including power grids and communication networks. The vulnerability of modern infrastructures to space weather events like solar flares and CMEs has gained attention, and efforts are being made to assess and mitigate the risks. However, it is important to note that the probability of a massive solar flare directly causing a widespread and long-term disruption of the power grid and mobile phone networks is relatively low based on historical records. Just get comfortable, Jem. The last severe solar storm, known as the Carrington event, occurred in 1859, when electrical infrastructure was much less developed. It caused telegraph systems to fail and generated auroras as far south as the Caribbean. Since then, there have been smaller scale solar storms that have caused localized disruptions, but not on the scale of the scenario that, you know, I described. Nonetheless, space weather events remain an area of active research, and precautions are being taken to enhance the resilience of critical infrastructure against such potential threats. monitoring systems, early warning systems, and preparedness plans are in place to mitigate the impact of solar flares and geomagnetic storms on Earth's technological systems. While the likelihood of the specific scenario mentioned is considered low, ongoing research and preparedness efforts continue to improve our understanding and ability to respond to space weather events. If a massive solar flare were to cause widespread disruption of the electric power grid and render mobile phones inoperable, it would have significant and far-reaching effects on various aspects of society. Here's a description of some potential consequences. Number one, power outages. The electric power grid would experience extensive disruptions leading to widespread power outages. This would result in the loss of electricity for homes, businesses, and critical infrastructures such as hospitals, transportation systems, and water treatment facilities. The duration of the power outage would depend on the extent of the damage and the time required for repairs. Number two, communication breakdown. With mobile phones rendered inoperable, a primary mode of communication would be severely affected. People would not be able to make calls, send text messages, or access the internet via mobile networks. This would hinder personal communication, emergency services, and coordination efforts. Number three, disruption of services. Many services reliant on electricity could be disrupted. This could include banking systems, online transactions, transportation networks, for example, traffic signals, railways, airports, internet connectivity, and public services like street lighting. Number four, supply chain disruptions. The disruption of the power grid would impact the supply chain of essential goods and services. Industries dependent on electricity, such as manufacturing and refrigeration, would experience production slowdowns or halts. This could lead to shortage of vital goods like food, medicine, and fuel. Number five, safety and security concerns. The lack of electricity and communication infrastructure could create safety and security challenges. Emergency services might face difficulties in responding to incidents, and law enforcement efforts could be hampered. The absence of street lighting and alarm systems might increase the risk of crime and accidents. Number six, economic impact. The disruption of the power grid and loss of communication capabilities would have severe economic consequences. Businesses would face operational challenges and potential revenue losses. Stock markets, financial transactions, and electronic commerce would be impacting, causing economic instability. Number seven, recovery efforts. Restoring the power grid after such a massive event would be a complex and time-consuming process. It would require assessing and repairing damaged infrastructure, ensuring that ensuring the availability of replacement parts and coordinating efforts across multiple sectors. Recovery could take weeks, months, or even longer, depending on the scale of the damage. It's important to note that the impact and severity of such an event would depend on various factors, including the intensity and duration of the solar flare, the resilience of the power grid, and the level of preparedness and response from authorities and communities. So, how likely? Who knows? It's just interesting for me to think, what would we do without our mobile phone? I would really, really, really please leave a comment. What do you think would happen if you didn't have your mobile phone? Let's forget a solar flare. Let's say something happened to you, just like what happened to me with loss of mobile phone. How would you manage without your phone? I'd love to know. This video is now done. Thank you very much for watching. Remember, cherish every moment. Every life matters. And I love you. And I won't be on for a few days. I'm really, really exhausted now. Okay. Thank you, guys. Bye.